Lawmakers on the Presidential Affairs Committee has probed the 1.7 billion shillings that the State House injected into 20 presidential industrial hubs across the country. The legislators raised concern over the progress and the future perspective of the skilling program. Among the questions raised was the issue of the land acquisition, transparency, as well as access to electricity at the training hubs.
If land belongs to a district, they give you that land in writing, and for how long are you there on that land? So do you have a document that spells out that?
Kampala Affairs State Minister Kabuye Chofa Togabye said the government is making efforts to extend electricity to all skilling centers in a phased manner.
The connectivity of electricity to sub-counties, yes, we agree as a country we still have areas where we don't have power or where power hasn't reached yet. But I want to assure you, just 1 or 2 weeks ago, Cabinet pronounced itself on this, and in our phasing, the plan is we connect districts, which I believe almost most of them are now connected.
The committee also raised an issue of recruitment criteria for the training hubs, citing illegalities such as segregation. However, Kabuye assured the committee of transparency in the recruitment exercise and reiterated the government's commitment to arrest and prosecute anyone involved in the segregation during recruitment.
You've raised the issue of, and I think my MP, the selection criteria, the kind of segregation and so on, that is wrong. Actually, if it happens, I'm happy I've had it reported, because the program is made for Ugandans, not for political ideology.
The presidential initiative on skilling was aimed at enabling the needy acquire skills such as hairdressing, embroidery, tailoring, knitting, weaving, shoemaking, bakery and confectionery, so that they can be self-employed. There was a standoff at Arua Park in Kampala after a private security guard allegedly attempted to shoot at KCC enforcement officers who were conducting an operation to rid the city of illegal vendors. According to the KCC enforcement officer, the guard was overpowered and later taken to KCCA court. KCCA conducted operations where it impounded goods and property belonging to illegal vendors and arrested several traders operating illegally on the city streets. With the aid of the pickup trucks, KCCA enforcement teams transported the arrested vendors to the KCCA court for prosecution. This operation did not spare illegal offloaders either. KCC officials urged the vendors to relocate to gazetted spaces in their respective markets. Security in and around Parliament Road and Nairobi Central Business District CBD has been beefed up today as Parliament debated an impeachment motion against Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua. Authorities said the decision to increase patrols and deploy anti-riot police was aimed at countering disruption to House proceedings. This fear stemmed from chaos in various parts of the country last Friday, where goons disrupted public participation in the impeachment motion. Kenya's deputy president is facing an impeachment motion in which he is accused of supporting anti-government protests in June and of being involved in corruption and other irregularities. He has defended himself and confirmed that he would appear before Parliament. A total of 291 legislators, more than 117 required by the Constitution, signed the impeachment motion before it was introduced, but a number of them from the Deputy President's region say they no longer support it after hearing contrary views from their constituents.